If you wish, you can be taught. If you apply yourself, you'll be shrewd. If you are willing to listen, you will learn. If you give heed, you will be wise. Frequent the company of the elders. Whoever is wise, stay close to him. Be eager to hear every godly discourse. Let no wise saying escape you. If you see a man of prudence, seek him out. Let your feet wear away his doorstep. Reflect on the precepts of the Lord. Let his commandments be your constant meditation. Then he will enlighten your mind, and the wisdom you desire, he will grant.
All right, well, welcome to Eastland Academy's ribbon cutting and blessing of our new construction. I'd like to take this moment right now to thank everyone who made this possible. To our board of directors, we have Mrs. Van Camp here representing, and also she was one of our lab designers, so thank you for taking the time. Our benefactors, our faculty, our volunteers, our construction crew, and our class of 2021 eighth graders are here helping us today. So thank you to Ms. Agnes for organizing this. Again, just like everything else here at East Lake, there's a lot of people, a lot of their love put into this to make this happen. During this time when really the world is very complicated and a little bit upside down, a little bit uncomfortable, things like this, you know, happening at East Lake is such a great sign of hope and such a great sign of growth. It really re-energizes all of us and reminds us, you know what, there's a future ahead of us. So this is such an important time at East Lake. We started 2001, so 19 years ago. We had one room schoolhouse, 13 children, 3 teachers. And today we stand here as we bless this beautiful addition with our new chaplain, Father Andrew. And we have 147 students. We have about 25 staff and faculty and a lot of love between all of us. So this is, when I cut this ribbon, I'm not just cutting it to the doors of the science lab. Really, this is to signify the moment where the school is open for everyone, for us to continue the mission to evangelize, to love others, but to teach, to educate, and to form each and every one of you and the future of East Lake. So again, thank you for joining us, for all those who are tuning in, and thank you for all of those who are actually here with us today. And most of all, thank you, God, for making this happen. Thank you for East Lake. So here we go.
And of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
May the God of wisdom, knowledge, and grace be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We gather here today to ask God's blessing on this new facility and on these students and their teachers at the beginning of this new academic year. Studies are hard, yet the reward is great. They lead to a knowledge of the world and of God. As we enter this new facility, let us thank God for the generosity of those who have made this possible, and commit ourselves to use this gift wisely and deepen in our knowledge of the mysteries of God's creation. We started off with 13 students, 3 teachers, and 1 room. And now we have, all the way up until today, we have this science lab. Now, of course, we know that what really makes the school is not the buildings, right? There are several teachers here who were teaching here even when we had half of what is the gym today. We didn't have the middle school here today. We didn't have the science lab. We didn't have any of these things, and yet it was still East Lake Academy, right? What really makes the school is, right, the students and the families and then the teachers. Of course, when we have such an awesome facility like this, it's even a better opportunity and occasion and a motivation to really try to delve more deeply into the mysteries of God's creation. What makes our world go around? What makes the laws of nature be the way that they are, the way that God has set everything in place? And that's really the purpose of this science lab, to try to delve a little bit more deeply into those mysteries of God's creation. there in this reading from Sirach, there was that phrase that I really love. If you see a man of prudence, seek him out. Let your feet wear away his doorstep. So figuratively, we could really wear away the doorstep of the teacher's doors here of the classrooms by coming and asking questions and by trying to figure out the mysteries of God's creation, right? All the teachers have studied, they are people of prudence, right? They are people that we can wear out their doorstep trying to find out the answers to God's creation, both his natural creation and, of course, the spiritual realities as well, right? That's such a big part of what we do here at the school. So hopefully all of the students will be motivated to do that, to seek out the doorstep of the teachers and wear them out. At our seminary in Connecticut, actually, for the day when they celebrated the rector, they actually made a doorstep, a doormat, out of this phrase. If you see a man of prudence, wear out his doorstep, and they put it right in front of his office, right? As a symbolism as well, that they all wanted to go to the rector for that prudence, for that guidance, for that spiritual guidance that they could receive from him. Hopefully today as well we can do the same, and throughout the rest of the year, by wearing out the doorstep of the teachers, right, and here the science lab as well, trying to figure out, trying to understand a little bit more about God's creation, about all that he has done for us.
For students, that the Spirit of God may grant them with the gifts of wisdom and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, fill us with your wisdom, Lord.
For teachers, that they may share their knowledge with gentleness, patience, and concern for their students. Let us pray to the Lord.
Fill us with your wisdom, Lord.
For those who seek knowledge of the things of this world, that they may always pursue God's wisdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Fill us with your wisdom, Lord.
For parents, the first teachers of their children, that their faith and love may be an example to us always, let us pray to the Lord.
Fill us with your wisdom, Lord.
We beg of you, through our ministry, make this school destined for the education of young minds a holy one. Pour on it the richness of your blessing and peace. Make it their salvation, as you did for Zacchaeus when you entered his house. Have your angels watch over it to drive away every hostile force. Fill those who teach here with the spirit of knowledge, wisdom, and fear of you. Support with heavenly grace those who study here, so that they may grasp with their minds what is taught for their salvation, keep it in their hearts, and follow it out in their conduct. May all who use this building be pleasing to you in the exercise of every virtue, so that they may sometime merit to be received into their eternal home in heaven. Through you, Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world, who live and are King and God forever and ever. Amen. Amen.